Hey guys, Jeff Dickinson here, and welcome to another unboxing from Entertainment Earth. Now, keep in mind, this is paid out of my own pocket. This is part of me collecting, and I'll put a link below, and for some of you guys who have read the description, yes, my Star Wars collection is growing. So, let's open the box. I'm always excited to see how I decided to expand my collection, and I'm doing something different recently. So let's show you this here. We got an invoice. Don't need to care about that, but let's show you what we got. It's always packaged very well. Oh yeah. Alright, so let's get rid of the packaging, the bags, the box, the invoice, get rid of all that. And let's see if I could, try and get the camera done right. Trying to do this justice for you guys. So I'm into these ever since I went to Dallas Vintage Toys and saw all those cool collectibles of lunchboxes, I've been after vintage lunchboxes, and there's been a new release of these lunchboxes. So let's see here. This is, if you saw my other, well, my other unboxing by lunchbox for Back to the Future, it just slid right out. But this one's kind of packaged in, so let's just break the seal. Alright. Back in the days, we used to have the thermos lunchboxes. Alright, so let's get a better look at this. Trying to do this justice. So this is a throwback to original 1977 lunchbox. There's the top of it. Let me see how I can do this right. I want to zoom in on some of this stuff because it's really cool. So the artwork is really old school deco. Let's back it out a little bit here. And let's show you the sides here. Go Chewbacca. Han Solo. Nice. The back end is just like the front end. Which is the old school days, it's how I used to do it. And they always had the sides being a little bit different. There you go. R2-D2 and C-3PO. And here is the bottom of it. I'll put a link below on how to get one of these. These are stickers here that you can remove. And what I want to do here is I want to just remove it. Because, you know what, I want to keep this, like, old school. Let's show you how it can be removed. And if we have any problems, I know we get some alcohol. Rubbing alcohol takes off the excess tape. I want to make sure we're preserving the integrity of the box. Now, will alcohol take away from the the worrying Star Wars? I don't know. I hope not. I didn't do this with the Back to the Future one. I didn't think about it. I wasn't sure if it's interfering with anything, but being this is old school Star Wars, you know, I'm all about the old schoolness, the collectibleness, the purityness of things. Some of you guys may not have remembered, but back in the days, very few products were released for Star Wars, and the ones that were released, you know, I really wish I kept my launch boxes. It's made by Thermos. Let's see here. Some of you purists are going to appreciate this. Some other you guys are like, one, why are you watching this guy take off stickers? Well, because back in the day, some of us really cared about our lunch boxes. Alright, so we got... Let's take this off. You know what? Let me get some rubbing alcohol. Hold on. Okay. I'm back. So I got some regular 91% alcohol. Put a little dabble on the cotton ball. I just want to brush it a little bit here and take the back end where it's dry to take off just the residue, because I don't want to strip any paint that may come off with alcohol, because I'm not 110% on how this tin is preserved. So from the looks of it, I think we're in the clear. Yes, it's taking off. There you go, it's a little sticky part right there. Alright, kind of like some of the models I play with, you know, they have a paint job that's been done a little bit too much, and just a little rubbing alcohol does do the trick. Alright, so there we go. See that, guys? Really cool. Let me cap my... You always want to cap your rubbing alcohol because it evaporates. Tips for youngsters. Alright, so here we go. So let's go ahead and do this a little bit. One more time here. So now we got a nice little thing here. I wish they didn't put stickers on it. They could put it on the packaging. That'd been cool. And this is really flush. Nothing, you know, raised. Been kind of cool if it did have raised things, Star Wars. And of course, here's the bottom end where we worked on. Give you a closer look. Right there is just a little more stickiness. There it goes, just rubbed right off there. There you go. See? And then, of course, back in the days, used to be a thermos in here. Because we used to keep our sandwiches, and we had a thermos to keep our drink cold. But, of course, that doesn't exist no more. So, for, you know, the money I paid, I think it was like $15 plus shipping. I'll put a link below how to get one of these, but this just got released, and yeah, it's pretty cool, man. There you go. When I was over at Dallas Vintage Toys, I had my hands on the Empire Strikes Back lunchbox by Thermos, the old school ones, and you know, it was $50. Thought about it, and I was like, you know what, I'll come back to it. And then, you know what, it was gone literally a few days later. So if you guys are hunting down these thermoses, the old school thermos lunch boxes, those in particular had some rust marks and didn't have a thermos, and they're still going for $50. I've been looking for these on eBay, and yeah, they're kind of pricey, especially if you got the thermos. They get up there in price. But yeah, man, not a bad deal. This is a reproduction, just kind of nod and wink from back in the days in the lunchbox years. And if you're like me, who went to school, a lot of us had paper bag lunches, but we were able to, sometimes our parents were able to score a metal lunchbox, which is way cool because we keep our sandwiches and drinks really cool, and we took it to school with us, and it was awesome. Well, guys, I appreciate you watching this unboxing. Please hit the like button if you thought this was cool, and we'll catch you on the next one. Laters, guys.